So we are very interested in trying to understand how the immune response works. And in particular, we are interested in trying to understand how you control, how you can dampen the immune response. Let's imagine that we have a cat, we have a potential infection, there are some invaders, we need to react against them. And so we have the first responders, the infantry, let's say, of the immune response, which are these cells that will come to the site immediately and will help us attack the pathogen. Now, there is a problem here because these cells can attack many things and can induce collateral damage. But these cells, the infantry, has a fundamental function, which is to call in the special forces to trigger the activation of a subset of cells known as T cells that can more specifically attack the pathogen. We found that T cells, these special forces, express, display a protein known as protein S, which can then activate a group of receptors. These are known as the TAM receptors that are expressed on these cells that are part of the infantry, these dendritic cells. And this is a way in which, once these special forces are called into play, they tell the dendritic cells that their job is done.
What we found is that protein S inhibit the activation of dendritic cells. That is important to temper the immune response.
What our study has revealed is that if you do not have this break, if you don't have this communication between the special forces and the infantry, the inflammatory response goes on. And these could be in part some of the causes of chronic inflammatory diseases and even autoimmune diseases.